This is Guglielmo Marconi, Italian inventor and physicist. He is known for his work in the field of long-distance radio transmission and is often regarded as the father of radio. Marconi was born in April 1874 in Bologna, Italy. He was half Italian and half Irish. His great-grandfather was a famous whiskey distiller. Luckily for us, Marconi preferred drinking from the well of scientific knowledge instead. One of the scientific developments during his teen years was the discovery by Heinrich Hertz that one could produce and detect electromagnetic radiation, or as it is now better known, radio waves. Now, one could always generate waves by splashing in a bath, but in the late 19th century, if one could artificially produce radio waves, then the dream of long-distance communication could be complete. Marconi built his own wave-generating equipment at his family's estate and was soon sending or transmitting long-distance signals to locations a mile away. After failing to interest the Italian government in his work, Marconi decided to try his luck in London. Britain recognized and valued his work, and he established a wireless telegraph and signal company in 1897. In 1901, Marconi built the first wireless telegraph capable of naturally transmitting long-distance electric telegraphic signals. In other words, a textual or symbolic message could be sent independently of what it was written on. This invention was the starting point for the radio that we listen to today. In 1909, he shared the Nobel Prize in Physics for the development of the radio telegraph system and the discovery of Marconi's law, which established the relationship between the height of an antenna and the maximum signaling distance of radio transmission. Grateful survivors of the RMS Titanic disaster presented Marconi with a gold medal in recognition of his radio, which helped save their lives in the 1912 disaster. He died in 1937 in Rome. In his honor, radio stations in America, England, and Italy, which had been broadcasting since the 1920s, broadcast several minutes of silence.